Okay, so nandito tayo ngayon ulit. Bibigyan ko kayo ng konting reviewer para makatulong sa inyong summative test. Kasi yung iba sa inyo ayaw nang tumingin ng mga previous video lessons natin. Okay? So, panoorin nyo to at sigurado ako makakatulong sa inyo. So, pinag-aralan natin is the two kinds of the sequences. The first one is arithmetic, which is characterized by having what we call as the common difference. So, natatawag nating sequence ang isang set of terms if they have what we call as the common difference. Ngayon, yung next term ng sequence na yon ay nakukuha kapag tayo ay nag-add ng ating tinatawag na common difference. So, nakukuha yung kasunod kapag tayo ay nag-add ng common difference. It's either add or subtract depende sa sign ng ating mga given. Okay? So, ito ang unang example. Find the 15th term of the sequence 5, 11, 17, 23, and 29. Kung mapapansin natin, this is an arithmetic sequence. Why? Because kapag minus natin yung pangalawang term, which is 11, sa first term, which is 5, we will get positive 6. And then at the same time, kapag minus natin yung third term, sa second term, makuha pa rin natin is positive 6. Therefore, this is our common difference. Or, gawin nating D. Okay, burin natin yan. So, that is the common difference or D. Okay? Now, meron dalawang paraan ng pagkuha ng 15th term. It's either you use mano-mano addition or you use the formula. Kung saan ka mas madadalian. Using the formula is to lessen the work. Using mano-mano is para isang step lang yung ginagawa mo. Hindi katulad ng formula na may multiplication, may kung ano-ano pang other operations. Sa pagmamano-mano, mag-add ka lang ng iyong mga given. Kaya, ang pinapayo ko kung saan ka mas madadalian. Kasi dapat parehas lang ang lalabas na sagot nun. Yung iba sa inyo nagkakamali kasi magkaiba yung lumalabas na sagot dahil dalawa yung ginagawa nila. Okay? So this time, una, papakita kung paano yung mano-mano. So syempre, dahil pag mamano-mano tayo, 15 ang hinahanap natin. This is our N. Ibig sabihin, maghanap tayo ng 15 term mula dito sa unang lima na to na magsisimula sa positive 5 na dagdagan ng plus 6, plus 6, plus 6, plus 6. So kung gagawin natin yon ng tuloy-tuloy, mag-add lang tayo ng plus 6 kada term para makuha natin yung kasunod until we reach the 15th term. Okay, so yan, plus 6, 71, plus 6, 77, plus 6, 83, 89, and yun na, eto na yung pang 15. Tama ba? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Therefore, the 15th term of this sequence is 89. Okay? Now, paano naman yung paggamit ng formula? So, using the formula, A sub N, ito yung formula ng paghawak ng 15, paghanap ng 15th term, we'll just have to substitute our given. First, A sub 1. A sub 1 is the first term. Ito yon, A sub 1. Ipapalit lang natin dito. N. Yan, yung dalawang N na yan. Kung pang ilan yung hinahanap natin. Pang 15. Okay, minus 1. The common difference, papalitan natin nung pagitan nila kanina, which is positive 6. Okay? So, substitute everything. We have A sub 15 is equal to 5, which is our first term, plus 15 minus 1 times 6. Ito lang yon, simpleng-simple. Unahin yung 15 minus 1 and that will be 14. And then, imumultiply lang natin dito kasi yun ang ibig sabihin ng dalawang parenthesis na magkadikit. 14 times 6 and that will give us 84. And 84 plus 5, since parehas silang negative, positive yung 5, positive yung 84, we just have to add. And that will give us 89. Yan, kung mapapansin nyo dun sa ating previous slide, sa pagmamano-mano natin, parehas dapat ng lalabas na sagot. Okay? Example number 2. Find the 12th term of the sequence negative 8, negative 17, negative 26, negative 35, and negative 44. Ito na yung given na lima. Okay, una, ito ay magiging arithmetic sequence. Bakit? Kapag nag-minus tayo ng second term, this is the second term, and this is the first term, hindi pwedeng baliktad. Yan. Negative 17, kasama yung sign, minus negative 8. Now, as you can see, this is a minus and this is a negative sign. Therefore, anong mangyayari? Magiging plus na siya. So, therefore, negative yung 17 at positive yung 8. Ayan, kung mapapansin ninyo, magkaiba sila ng sign, we have to subtract. And 17 minus 8 is 9. Copy the sign of the higher digit or the larger number, which is negative. So, kaya negative 9. So, ganun din, the third term, minus natin yung second term. Dalawang magkasunod. And that will also give us, yan, magkaiba ng sign, negative 9. So, kung magmano-mano tayo, starting from negative 8, or sa negative 44 ka na, para panlima ka na, mag-add lang tayo ng plus negative 9. So, kaya kung mapapansin ninyo, the digits or the numbers are getting higher because negative yung ating mga terms, at the same time, negative yung ating common difference. Kaya nagiging addition yung pangyayari dahil parehas silang negative. And therefore, the 12th term, ayan, the 12th term, parang kulang, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, sakto pala, 12. The 12th term is negative 107. Okay, tignan natin kung yan din ang makukuha natin if we use the formula. Yan, substitute the given, n will be 12. A sub 1 will be negative 8. And the common difference is, kung ano nakuha natin kanina, negative 9. Okay, tuloy-tuloy lang. Substitute, negative 8 plus 12 minus 1 multiplied by negative 9. Yan, 11 times negative 9. Ang mangyayari ay negative 99. Ngayon dito, sa part na to, negative yung 8, negative din yung 99. Therefore, we will add. And that will give us negative 107. Okay? So, parehas sila dapat doon sa ating pagmamano-mano. Next example, find the 21st term of the sequence a sub 1 is equal to 17 and the common difference is negative 7. So, this time, given yung ating a sub 1 at yung ating common difference. So, alam na natin arithmetic siya. So, kailangan lang natin magmano-mano starting from positive 17. And since magkaiba sila, positive yung term, negative yung common difference, nagiging minus siya. So, 17 plus negative 7, positive 10 plus negative 7. Dito, nag-iba na ng sign. Why? Because 3, positive, plus negative 7. So, magkaiba sila ng sign. Kaya, naging subtraction at kinuha yung negative. And then, sa mga susunod, parehas na ng sign. Kaya, naging addition. And then, we will arrive at the 21st term, which is negative 123. Okay? So, tingnan natin yung ating paggamit ng formula. So, substitute, n will be 21. A sub 1 will be 17. Ayan, given na. Laki-laki. Common difference, ayun na rin. And n ay parehas lang nitong 21. Okay? Substitute. Yan. So, this time, 20 times negative 7. Magmumultiply tayo na magkaiba yung sign, kaya ang lalabas is negative. So, negative 140. Okay, dito ulit. Yung 17 ay positive. Okay? Yung 140 ay negative. So, kailangan nating mag-subtract. So, negative 140 tsaka 17. Subtraction, it will give us 123. And since mas malaki yung negative, kaya naging negative 123. Okay. So, now, another one. Find the 13th term of the sequence a sub 1 is equal to negative 24 and the common difference is 11. So, starting from negative 24, magkaiba ulit ng sign, kaya magiging subtraction siya. Yan, magiging negative 13, negative 2. Dito sa part na to, negative yung 2 plus 11. Magkaiba sila ng sign, kaya subtraction na. Naging positive na since mas malaki na yung 11. And then onwards, nagiging plus 11 na lang. Positive na siya kasi, kaya puro positive na. And that will give us 108. The 13th term is 108. So, gamit yung formula. Substitute again. We have 13th term. Negative 24 yung ating a sub 1. At ating common difference is 11. So, 12 times 11 ang uunahin pagkatapos mag-minus, which will give us 132. Now, dito ulit, magkaiba ulit ng sign. Negative yung 24, positive yung 132. Subtraction. And, mas malaki yung positive this time, kaya ang sagot is positive 108. Okay, yun na yung pagkuha ng nth term. So, ang pinag-aralan natin dito is getting the nth term. Okay? This time, punta man tayo sa pagkuha ng common difference para magamit natin sa arithmetic means. Remember that arithmetic means meaning ito yung meron tayong hinahanap na term sa pagitan ng dalawang terms. Okay? So, meron tayong tatlo. We have 14. And then, tatlong arithmetic terms. 1, 2, 3. And then, the number 38. So, using the same formula, papalitan lang natin yan. And kung ilan sila? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Therefore, ang n natin is 5. A sub 1 yung ating unang term. Okay? And, same. The common difference, ito yung hinahanap natin kapag arithmetic means. Ito yung nawawala. So, substitute again. Ayan. Itong a sub n, ito yung dulo. Ayan. 38. Yan yung gagamitin natin. So, 38 is equal to 14 plus n is 5 kasi 5 sila. Minus 1 and then the missing is the common difference. Now, 5 minus 1 times d, that will give us 4d. The goal here is to eliminate positive 14. To eliminate positive 14, we will just put negative 14. Para positive 14, tsaka negative 14, mawala na sila. Magiging 0. Pero sa kabila ng equal sign, sa kabilang side, 38 positive, negative yung 14, kaya ang lalabas is 24. Subtraction. Okay? Kitang-kita naman, 38 minus 14. And then, ang may iwan is 4D. Again, to eliminate 4, we will have to multiply by 1/4 or simply divide sa 4. Kung ano yung number na kasama niyan, yun din yung pang d-divide natin. So, nawala na siya, naging 1 na lang. And then, 24 divided by 4, we have 6. Okay? So, associative property of equality, pagpalitin, we have D is equal to 6. Meron na tayong common difference. Ngayon, saan gagamitin yung common difference? So, mula sa 14, mag-add tayo ng 6. So, 14 plus 6, 20. Ito yung ating second or the first arithmetic mean. Ito yung ating susunod, 26 plus 6 again. And then, nakumpleto na natin yung tatlong arithmetic means. So, the three arithmetic means between 14 and 38 is 20, 26, and 32. Para sigurado, mag-add kayo ng 6, 32 plus 6, ang lalabas dapat yung dulo. Okay? Next, example. 4 arithmetic means between negative 21 and positive 29. Ayan, 4 naman yung missing natin. So, meron tayong 6 terms. Yung ating n ay 6. So, substitute again, a sub n, etong 29, a sub 1, etong 21, negative. N, 6, the common difference, yung hinahanap natin. Yan. 29, ayun, sinubstitute. Negative 21, substitute again, and 6 terms minus 1. That will give us 5D. Eliminate negative 21. Of course, ang kabaliktaran ng negative 21 pagdating sa sign is positive 21. And then, positive 21, and then positive 21 din dito, ang mangyayari, magiging subtraction, magiging 0 siya. And then this time, parehas naman silang addition, positive. Kaya tayo ay mag-a-add dahil parehas silang positive. Magiging 50. Yan. And then eliminate 5 by dividing both sides by 5. This will be 1. And then 50 divided by 5, that will give us 10. So therefore, the common difference is 10. Okay? Gamit yung 10, magsimula tayo ng negative 21. Negative 21 plus 10, ayan. Kasi magkaiba sila ng sign, this is negative, while this one is positive. So therefore, negative 21 plus 10, that will give us negative 11. Magkaiba ng sign. Again, negative 11 plus 10, magkaiba ulit ng sign. Kaya naging subtraction, mas malaki yung 11, kaya negative 1. Ganun ulit, negative 1 plus 10, magkaiba ulit, subtraction. But this time, mas malaki yung positive, kaya positive 9. And then 9 plus 10 will give us 19. And 19 plus 10 will give us 29. So therefore, the 4 arithmetic means between negative 21 and 29 is negative 11, negative 1, 9, and 19. Okay. So, example again. 3 arithmetic means between 6 and 9. Yan, tatlo. So, meron tayong 5 terms. So, substitute once again, yung pinakadulo, that is 9, equals a sub 1, which is 6. And then 5 minus 1 times the common difference. Operate. Magiging 4D. Kailangan ma-eliminate yung positive 6. Magiging negative 6. Okay? And then 9 minus 6 will give us 3. Divide both sides by positive 4. Ayan, this time. Sir, hindi divisible. Okay, ganito lang. Tayo ay nag-answer ng fraction if the given are fraction. Okay? Tanda na. Para mas madaling ilagay kung ano yung magiging sagot. Although, tama naman. Tama. You can answer in the form of fraction and you can answer in the form of decimal. Okay? So, this time, ang mangyari, ang gagawin ko na lang munang decimal since hindi naman fraction yung hinahanap natin. And that will give us 0.75. Okay? I-add lang natin. 6 plus 0.75, we will have 6.75, plus 0.75, 7.5, plus 0.75, that will give us 8.25. Therefore, the 3 arithmetic means between 6 and 9 is 6.75, 7.5, and 8.25. Okay? So, yun yung pagkuha ng arithmetic means. Dun tayo sa last part ng ating arithmetic sequence, which is finding the sum. Pag sinabing sum, it means that kabuuan, yung buong pinagsama-samang terms pag inad natin lahat. Okay? So, using this formula, S sub n is equal to n over 2, and then 2a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. Okay? Substitute lang, n. Ilan yung sum na kailangan natin kunin? 10. N, yan, parehas. Yun to dyan, andyan na yan, hindi yan mabagbago. A sub 1, first term. Ayan, palit. And then again, yung N, 10. And then, yung common difference, o kunin lang natin, 13 minus 5. And that will give us positive 8. Okay? Operate isa-isa. Ito, 10 over 2. Anong sagot dyan? 10 divided by 2. Anong sagot sa 5 times 2? Anong sagot sa 10 minus 1 times 8? Again, ulitin natin. Murayin natin. Murayin natin. Ulitin natin yung proseso kung paano nangyari. Una, ito muna, 10 over 2. Sulat nyo yung sagot. And then, bracket. Anong sagot sa 2 times 5? Again, and then plus. Anong sagot sa 10 minus 1? And then, times 8. yan yung lalabas. 10 over 2, that is 5. 2 times 5, that is 10. And then, 10 minus 1 is 9 times 8, 72. Dito, parehas silang positive. So, ang mangyari is addition. And then, 82 times 5 is 400 term. Therefore, the sum of the first 10 terms of the sequence is 410. Ngayon naman, magmamano-mano tayo. Tulad ng ginawa natin kanina, hahanapin muna natin yung pang-sampo. Yung sampo, lahat ng sampung terms hanapin natin. Ganito yung way kapag nagmamano-mano. So, mula 5 hanggang 77, yan yung sampung terms. And then, ang gagawin lang natin is i-add natin. 5 plus 13 plus 21 and so on hanggang sa makarating ng 5 plus 77. At kapag in-add nyo yan, ang lalabas is 410. Okay? So, it's up to you kung anong gusto mong gamiting process or way. Next, pagkuha ng sum using the formula again. Yan. 19 yung hinahanap natin. 19 terms. Okay? 19. Yan. A sub 1 is negative 12. N is, again, 19. And 9. Paano nakuha yung 9? Negative 3 minus negative 12. Negative 3, second term, minus negative 12. At since parehas yung negative, magiging negative 3 plus 12. Magkaiba ng sign, subtraction, that will be equal to 9. Mas malaki yung 12, kaya positive yung 9. Okay, operate 19 over 2. Ito, multiply. Ito, minus, and then multiply. Yan. Okay? So, 2 times negative 12 is negative 24. 19 over 2 is 9.5. 19 minus 1, 18 times 9, 162. Kung mapapansin nyo dito, negative yung 24, positive yung 162. So, subtraction tayo. Magiging 138. Mas malaki kasi yung positive. And then, multiply sa labas. Multiply. We will have 1,311. Okay, ganun din yung pagkuha kapag mano-mano. Kukunin natin yung 19. So, tayo ay magpa-plus 9 ng plus 9. 6 plus 9, 15. Plus 9, 24. Plus 9, hanggang umabot tayo ng 19 terms. Okay? Pagkatapos ay i-add natin lahat. So, negative 12 plus negative 3. Ngayon, kung wala kayong scientific calculator, ihuli nyo na itong dalawang tong negative. I-add nyo muna lahat ng positive and then minus 12 and then minus 3. Kung wala kayong scientific calculator na may negative. Okay? And then, that will give us the same answer, 1,311. Okay? Now, tapos na tayo sa arithmetic sequence. Doon tayo sa other kind of sequence. Which is geometric sequence. This time, the characteristic or what gives a sequence as geometric is what we call as the common ratio. The common ratio is obtained by multiplying, the next term is obtained. Yung susunod na term is obtained by multiplying. Nagmumultiply tayo sa common ratio. Paano ba kinukuha ang common ratio? Magdi-divide lang tayo ng dalawang magkasunod. Okay, find the 8th term of the geometric sequence 2, 8, 32, 2, 8, and 32. So, pag mano-mano, ang gagawin lang natin, ano bang common ratio? 8 divided by 2. And that will give us positive 4. So, therefore, makukuha yung susunod kapag nag-multiply tayo sa 4. So, 2 times 4, 8. 8 times 4, 32. 32 times 4, 128. Times 4. Times 4 hanggang tayo ay maka-8 term na. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Therefore, we have 32,768. Now, using the formula naman. The formula is a sub n is equal to a sub 1 times r raised to n minus 1. Ganun pa din. N, 8. Pang 8 yung inano natin. A sub 1 yung unang term. And then the common ratio yung kinuha natin. So, substitute. Ayan. Unahin lang tong exponent that will give us 7. Now, anong ibig sabihin nito? Hindi yan 4 times 7 katulad ng ginagawa ng iba. That is 7 4. 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. 7 4. And then, i-multiply lang natin sa nasa labas. So, therefore, multiply lang lahat yan. Times, 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 hanggang sa maubos. And that will give us 32,768. Same answer. How about this example? Negative 3, 6, negative 12. Okay? If you can look closer, if you analyze, makikita ninyo na yung negative, positive, negative, nagpapalitan ng sign. That will give us a clue that the common ratio is negative. Okay? So, mag-divide tayo. 6 divided by negative 3. Magkaiba ng sign, magiging negative. 6 divided by 3, 2. Therefore, our common ratio is negative 2. Okay? Mano-mano. Negative 3 times 2, negative 2, naging positive 6 times negative 2, negative 12 times negative 2, hanggang sa makaabot tayo ng pang-anim na pang-pitong term, 7th, yung hinahanap natin. Okay? So, using the formula, kung gusto nyong gumamit ng formula, yan, substitute lang, pang-pito, hinahanap natin. Ito yung unang term, ito yung ating common ratio, and then 7 minus 1. Unahin lang to, that will give us 6. Again, this is not negative 2 times 6, but rather, 6 na negative and then multiply lang tayo dire-diretso. Negative 3 times negative 2, negative 2 times negative 2, 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 and that will give us negative 192. Okay? Next, find the 6th term. So, same process lang. Oh, alisin natin to. Mali yan. 64, 16, and 4. So, katulad nito, 16 over 64 naman tayo ngayon. Yan, hindi siya divisible, sir, kasi mas malaki yung denominator. Anong gagawin? We just have to lowest term. Saan ba pwedeng i-divide ang 16 at 64? Simula natin sa pinakamababang number, pwede ang 2. Divide natin sa 2, magiging 8 over 32. Saan pwedeng i-divide? Pwedeng malaking number na. Pero kung gusto nyo, unti-unti, pwedeng maliit na number. So, divide ulit natin sa 2 para maging 4 over 16. Divide ulit sa 2 para maging 2 over 8. At divide ulit sa 2 kasi pwede pa rin hanggat pwede maging 1/4. Pero pwedeng diretso yan kasi ang 16 at 64 ay pwedeng i-divide sa 16. Kaya ang magiging sagot 16, 16, 1. 64, 16, 4. So, etong ating common ratio, positive 1/4. Yan. Oh, burahin natin, nakasagabal. Yan. Kung mapapansin nyo, ito yung pagmamano-mano. Kapag ito ang ano ng pagmamano-mano, medyo mahirap siya kapag fraction na. So, ang mangyari dito is 64, dahil fraction yung ating common ratio, 64 times 1/4. So, 64 times 1 divided by 4. Again, 64 times 1 divided by 4. Ah, negative pala talaga yun. Negative to. Sorry. So, therefore, negative yung ating common ratio. Hindi ko na, ano, hindi pala dapat yun binura. So, dahil negative yan, palitan lang yung sign. Yun ang ibig sabihin nun, palitan yung sign. Okay? So, negative 1/4, 64 times 1, and then divided by 4, 16. Again, 16 times 1 divided by 4, and then 4 times 1 divided by 4. So, 1 times 1 is 1 divided by 4, eh hindi naman pwedeng maging whole number. So, 1 divided by 4, that is 1/4. Ngayon, yung 1/4, at ta-times mo sa 1/4, buray natin yan sa gabal. Negative 1/4, tatandaan. So, imumultiply natin ngayon dalawang fraction. Ganito lang yung kasimple. 1/4 times negative 1/4. Multiply the numerator to the numerator. 1 times 1 is 1. 4 times 4 is 16. Negative siya dahil magkaiba ng sign. Now, Pwede pa bang i-lowest term ang 1 tsaka 16? Wala na. Wala nang pwedeng i-divide. Therefore, that is the next term. Okay? So, naka-anim na tayo. Ito yung pang-anim. Paano yung mano-mano niya? Again, substitute. Yan. Magiging 5. And then, 5 negative 1/4. So, dahil whole number to, ganito lang gagawin. Katulad yung ginawa natin kanina. 64 divide, times 1 divided by 4. Kung ano yung sagot, again, times 1 divided by 4. Kung ano ulit yung sagot, times 1 divided by 4. Kung ano ulit yung sagot, times 1. Dahil whole number siya, kapag fraction na, ganito na ang gagawin. Pag pares pa, hindi yan nakangiti ah, hindi yan tao. Kapag fraction na, yan, ganito na yung gagawin. So hanggat hindi pa fraction, times numerator divide the denominator. And that will give us negative 1 over 16. Next example. Ayan, ganun ulit. Ito yung pagmamano-mano. So, paano kumuha ng common ratio kapag ganito? Okay? Ang magkakasunod na number is 4 over 9 divided by 2/3. Negative. Okay? So, alam naman natin, magkaiba yung sign, negative yung sagot yan. Okay? Ganito po ang gagawin, ha? 4 times 3, that is 12. Tama? 9 times 2, that will give us 18. Paano ulit nangyari? Numerator times sa pinakailalim. And then, yan. Yan tinatawag na yung FOIL method. Happy man. Or sa numbers, ang tag doon? Cross multiply. Yan. So, simplify lang natin to. 12. Saan ba pwedeng divide ang 12 at 18? Diba? Sa 6. So, divide mo sa 6 yung 12, magiging 2. Divide mo sa 6, yung 18, magiging 3. So, therefore, our common ratio is negative 2/3. Okay, alam na yung common ratio, negative 2/3. Burahin natin yan. So, the common ratio is negative 2/3. Paano naman gagawin kapag ganyan? So, negative 2/3 times negative 2/3. So, katulad nung ginawa natin sa fraction kanina, negative 2/3 tapos negative 2/3. Numerator sa numerator, yan, lumabas 4. Denominator sa denominator, lumabas 9. Dahil magka, ay, 4 pala yung negative, no? So, therefore, our common ratio is positive. Okay, positive pala siya. May negative pa pala dito. So, therefore, positive yung common ratio. Yan, pare-pareha sila ng sign. Tanda na, sa geometric sequence, kapag positive ang common ratio, pare-parehas ng sign. Clue na yon sa inyo. Yan, ganun ulit. 4 times 2, 8. 9 times 3, 27. 8 times 2, 16. 27 times 3, 81. Ganun ulit, paulit-ulit. Ganyan pag mano-mano. Using the formula, burahin natin yon. Ay, highlighter pala yon. Sorry. Yan. So, using the formula again, 6 na 2/3. So, ganun pa rin. Dahil wala naman tayong pwedeng i-lowest term, multiply lang natin 2 times 2 times 2 hanggang sa umabot sa dulo. And then 3 times 3 hanggang umabot sa dulo. And isa lang yung negative, kaya negative 128 over 2187. Okay. Ito naman tayo, geometric mean naman tayo. Although, fully explained na siya dun sa ating video lesson. Alam ko fully explained na siya. Kaya, papahapyawan na lang natin to. Okay? Fully explained na siya. Kaya balikan nyo na lang yung video lesson ng lesson 3.1. Basta yung geometric means. Okay? So, ibig sabihin lang yan, meron tatlong geometric means between 5 and 80. Dito lang medyo nalilito. Finding the common ratio. So, 5 minus 1, magiging 4. Ito, 80 divided by 5. Kaya naging 16. Ngayon, fourth root, ibig sabihin, anong number yung apat na beses mong imumultiply to get the number 16? So, mag-isip ka ngayon, anong number yung pwedeng apat na beses mong imumultiply to get the number 16? So, magsimula tayo sa pinakamaliit na hindi 1. That is 2. So, apat na 2. 2 times 2 is 4. Dalawa na. Times 2 is 8. Tatlo na. Times 2 is 16. So, ito yung number na apat na beses mo i-multiply sa sarili niya, malalabas ay 16. Therefore, that is positive and negative 2. Bakit positive and negative? Kasi even ito. Kapag even yung ating index, positive negative ang sagot. Okay? So, multiply lang from there. Ayan. Positive lang kinuha mo natin ngayon. Okay? Times 2, times 2, times 2. Next. Geometric means. Ganun pa rin. 192, eto yun ha. Yung dulo, tsaka yung una. Yung negative, huwag nyo munang pansinin yan. Ibig sabihin lang yan, kung mapapansin nyo, magkaiba yung sign ng first and the last term. Therefore, our common ratio is supposed to be negative. Tandaan yan ha. Magkaiba kasi, kaya negative. Okay? Now, third root of 64. Cube root of 64. Anong number yung tatlo beses mo i-multiply sa sarili niya to get 64? 2 ba? 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. Hindi pwede. 3. 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. Hindi pa din. Next, 4. 4 times 4 times 4, that is 64. So therefore, our common ratio is negative 64. As negative 4. So ganun ulit. Mula negative 3 times negative 4, positive 12. Sorry, mali. Times negative 4, negative 48. Times, wala na, dulo na pala yun. So, therefore, our geometric means are 12, positive 12, 12, and negative 48. Okay, alternate dapat. Next. Yan. Dito naman magkaiba. As you can see, mas malaki na naman yung denominator. So, ang gagawin lang natin is to lowest term. Saan pa pwedeng i-divide ang 18 at 144? Di ba sa 2? Divide natin sa 2, ang kakalabasan na neto ay 9 over ilan to? 72. Tama? Oh, 18 na yung pinakadulo. So, divide ulit natin sa 3. Pwedeng i-divide sa 3. Sa 2 ulit. Magiging yan, 1 over 8. Dinivide sa una, sa 2, tapos divide sa 3. Or gusto mo diretsong 18 na agad. Or pwedeng 9. Kung saan parehas, basta parehas. Kaya ang lumabas is 1 over 8, dinivide parehas. Ngayon, third root, ibig sabihin tatlong number, tatlong beses. 1, simpleng-simple. Siyempre, ang sagot kapag 1, 1 na yon. Ngayon, pareha sila dapat, pati yung denominator, 8. So, 8, cube root ng 8, tatlong beses, alam naman natin, ang lalabas is 2. Okay? So, ganun pa rin, 1 half dapat yan. Times 1 half, ayan, whole number. 144 times 1 divided by 2, negative 72. Negative 72 times 1 divided by 2, negative 36. Okay? So, ganun lang yon. Ito yung dalawang terms na hinanap natin. Ngayon, dapat yan ay hindi siya pwede maging positive-negative. Bakit? Ito is odd number. Therefore, isa lang yung sign. It's either positive or negative. Dahil parehas ng sign yung umpisa at dulo, therefore, the common ratio is positive. Okay? Tandaan nyo yan. And then, find two geometric means between negative 1 and negative 154. Negative 54. Ito naman, dalawang fraction naman. Ganito lang ang gagawin dyan. Katulad nung ginawa natin kanina, kapag ganyan, multiply nyo muna to, tsaka ito. Anong lalabas? 2 over 54. And then, lowest term, divide sa 2 parehas, dahil pwede parehas sa 2, magiging 1 over 27. Okay? So, 4 minus 1 is 3. Baka nagtataka pa rin kung bakit 4 yon, ilan ba yung terms? So, cube root ng 1, alam naman nating 1, and then anong number yung tatlong beses mo i-multiply para maging 27? That will give us 1/3. Ngayon, kung mapapansin ninyo, ito ulit ay add, so therefore, isa lang ang sign ng ating common ratio. At dahil pareha sila ng negative, kaya positive ang ating common ratio. Yan. Ngayon, paano to? Katulad kanina, 1 times 1 is 1, 2 times 3 is 6. Negative kasi magkaiba. 1 times 1 is 1, 6 times 3 is 18. Ngayon, magpaiba ulit ng sign, kaya negative. So, ganun lang yung paggamit ng pagkuha ng ang geometric means. If still, nalilito ka pa din, balikan mo lang yung ating mga video lessons or ulit-ulitin mo lang to. Now, paano sa geometric sum? As I can recall, yung geometric sum natin ay maayos ang pagkaka-explain sa video lesson, yung pinakahuling lesson, which is lesson 3.3, kung tama ako. Kaya, yon ay siguradong balikan nyo na lang kung kailangan nyo pa rin ng guide. Okay? Pwede ulit dun magmano-mano or pwedeng gumamit ng formula, katulad ng arithmetic sum. Okay? It's up to you. Now, good luck sa iyong summative test and please, huwag hulaan. Importante ang summative test. It will be as comparable to our periodical exam. Okay? So, good luck. And ask questions if you want.